Well, that was a big burp.
It's recording now.
Oh, nearly walked into a fucking lamp post.
There you go.
We're here, lad.
That's Sky, lad.
I bought a clipper last week, lad, and left it here. Where is it?
What's that?
I bought a clipper last week and left it here. Where is
What's
it?
What's a clipper?
One of them, what you've got in your hand.
What, a fucking lighter?
So where's that? That's what you fucking preach, don't you?
Hello?
When you say you're here, what you mean is you've got no idea where the fuck I live.
The guy knows you're coming in like 5-10 minutes, so he's going to stand in the entrance for you. Alright, let's see in a sec. Alright.
Great, he does a lot of TV over here in the UK. Very well researched.
Okay. Evening all. It's Caprice here. Now we are at the O2 Indigo, covering Ultimate Boxxer. So, just doing all the rehearsals now. It's a good little setup, to be honest. It's got like a backdrop to the ring, so there's got 360 degree views throughout the ring. It's kind of just like banners at the back, like I'm sure you've seen. Kind of reminds me of sort of a bit of a Rocky vibe. Do you know, like when James Brown's coming down? I live in America. Yeah. Bit like that. So yeah, I'm getting some Rocky vibes from this, and hopefully there's a fairy tale Rocky story tonight. Because like I said, there's 8 guys and there's 40 grand on the line. So whoever wins it is in for a good time, a good bit of exposure for him, and raises the profile. Hopefully if there's any part-time pros there, that helps them go full-time and sort of push on and achieve the goals. So yeah, we're gonna go and have a few drinks, have some food, etc. And then just have a mingle around throughout the night. And yeah, see you in the next one. This is the view what the fighters will see as they're preparing to make their entrance into the ring. Carpet's here, running up. There's your Rocky IV ring in the back there, all the banners of all the fighters, etc. Hopefully that bar opens soon and we can get a couple of bevs in as well. Go and mingle amongst the fans.
Hello, and a very
try and catch Paulie Malignaggi as well.
So. Extraordinary.
You win that prize money tonight, what's the first thing you're buying?
First thing I'm buying? A dance.
You're buying a what?
Yeah, you heard that.
8 competitors will have their eyes on a big payday.
Mix my style up to whatever opponent I've got in front of me.
Everyone's got time to lose at the end of the day, and I'm there to make a statement.
Red corner, Daryl Church! On Chelmsford, Essex, dazzling Daryl Church! From Portsmouth, Hampshire, El Toro, Joel McIntyre!
Of your winner and progressing through to the semi-final, Joel McIntyre!
Reese here at Boxing Guru, and I'm over here with Joel McIntyre. He's won the first quarter final. He'll be facing Dex Spellman now in the semis. How did you feel there, mate? Good knockdown in the first round. Did you try and conserve a bit of energy, not try and force that stoppage, or what was the plan?
Yeah. I didn't want to go too mad. Trying to go crazy and pick the boy out. I mean, he was quite cagey anyway. Obviously, not as confident to come forward. It was quite hard to deal with. But, yeah, they got worse after the knockdown, unfortunately. But, you know, it was decent. It was good 3 rounds warm up.
And
crazy. It's nice.
And is there anything that you'll take from Dex Spellman's fight? Have you seen that fight at all? Did you see?
I caught bits of it. Yeah, I see bits of it.
Thank you, right too much.
It's not going live. This will be played days later. But
yeah.
At the end of the day,
we got a plan.
We've seen a few things that we like. So yeah.
Are you both bangers? It looks like you both come to fight. So should make for a cracking fight, mate. Looking forward to it. All the best in the semi final.
The best I do.
Yeah. All the best in the semi final. See you soon. In a bit. Reese here, Boxing Guru. We're here at Ultimate Boxxer, and here we have the winner with a sensational knockout, Dex Spellman. Second quarter finalist now going into the semi-finals. Great performance. How did you assess that performance, Dex?
Yeah, it was all right. It was a lot of rugged, but two tactics going into it. What Carl said, my coach. Think you can pick him off, pick and poke him all night, and box his ears off, or you can take it to him and test his chin. And came here for a shootout, so that's what I've got.
Yeah, you both went for it. You took a few yourself as well. I mean, didn't make it easy for you, but yeah. Unreal knockout at the end, and luckily he got back up from that. Was there a few tense moments though when you was waiting in the corner? Because it did take a while for him to get back up.
Yeah, but thankfully he's all right. Just been informed he's okay as well. So I'm keeping an eye on him. And fair play to him, you know, he took the shots in there. He's a very handy kid himself.
Yeah, he is.
Raw and rugged, but I didn't need to go out and get myself caught in a fight like that. But it's next one against McIntyre, you're going to see something different. I'm not stupid, and I know how to read people, and I don't want him in there.
And did you take anything from McIntyre's last fight? Anything that you think you can exploit?
Yeah, I'm going to do it.
Not giving anything away, mate.
No, but
that was brilliant, mate. Brilliant performance, and good luck in the semi final, buddy.
Thank you.
See you soon. Cheers. Nice one. Come on,
man. I didn't count. You know what? Yes.
Shakan Pitters just won his quarter-final bout. He's now going into the semi-finals, progressing on. Knockdown in that fight as well. It's been a knockdown in nearly every fight we've had so far. It's been a good night. So you can all bang. You're all going for it. You all want it. So
How did you feel in there, mate? Talk us through it.
I felt great, man. As I was just doing, just listening to my corner man, Paul Cunahan. You know, he just said, you know, go in there, box, enjoy it, box clever. And that's what we've done, you know what I mean? We've got, obviously, a lot to give. And, you know, I thought we can go in this tournament and definitely win it.
Fantastic, mate. And anything you've seen in your opponent going into the semi-final which you think you can exploit? Are you not giving it away this early?
It doesn't matter, you know, I'm just going to do what I do best, go out there and win. And just listen to my corner men, as I say, man. You know, they've got the brain, find the business, John Pegg and Paul Cunahan. I'll just listen to them both in the corner and we're going to progress forward to the finals.
Hang on, man. Appreciate it. Good luck with that, mate. Also here.
What's up?
Just took him by surprise. got Love Island's Idris Virgo here, the Casanova himself. What's going on, man?
Sam,
man,
you're right.
Yeah, I'm good, mate. I'm good, mate. You're fighting on the undercard tonight.
Yeah.
When was your last bout? And how long you had out? And how are you feeling going into this one now?
My last bout was June 30th.
Right.
Then a bit of
pop. Yeah.
One decision points.
Yeah.
One every round. Quite comfortable this round. This time I have promised that I do want a knockout. As Soggy said, there's no point forcing knockouts, it ain't gonna happen.
So yeah.
Over the flow, over technique, and
the knockouts will come.
There we go. It just finished my sentence then.
That's the one, big man. That's the one. Well, mate, we'll be looking forward to seeing you, mate. All fans of Homewell as well, mate. And cheers for that one. Really appreciate it, brother. Nice one. Hey guys, it's Reese here, boxing guru, and I've run into the man, many impersonations, Darren Farley.
Of course, I'm very proud to be here. It's a very exciting night. I'm absolutely buzzing.
Any comments, Wayne?
Yeah, I think obviously it's always great to come down to watch the cricket. Happy days.
Mate, you put a smile on my face, so
thank you, buddy.
Really appreciate that, buddy.
Thanks, for
thanks a lot.
Thank
cheers, pal.
Cheers, mate.
I just need to know.
Right, guys, we're ready. The semi-finals, we've had a fantastic few fights for the quarter-finals now. We had loads of knockdowns, we had a sensational knockout by Dex Bellman for the second fight as well. He's now due to go on next. He's fighting Joel McIntyre, who had first round knockdown himself. Both going for it, both can bang. Hopefully we've got fireworks. And we've also got Peter Zeus also against Bacon as well. I'm just gonna get a couple of interviews with the fighters. I've already seen some of them. So yeah, I'm gonna get round, get their thoughts going forward, and then hopefully we're in for a explosive semi-final rounds and then a big final in the end. It's been really good so far. It really is like, it's not like you're in a boxing event. It's like you're in a nightclub with boxing in it. That's the kind of vibe that you get. I mean, you got Charlie Sloth playing the tunes, absolute bangers, everyone's dancing, everyone's singing. I mean, they're normally rowdy places anyway, but I mean, this is something different, something new, unique, really. The fact that they've done the second one with light heavyweights has really proved the thing, because I mean, the lads have been letting the leather fly, and they've been getting caught on the chin, they've been going down, they've really been putting it all on the line for that 40 grand and that golden robe. So yeah, brilliant so far. I really do recommend it. But let's all get fireworks as well for the semi-finals and the finals. I'm going to try and grab a few interviews as well. We've got Anthony Yard knocking about. I've done loads of bits with Anthony before. It'll be my first time meeting him. So fingers crossed he takes my interview well. I'm going to ask him if he can give me a smash on the body bag as well, which we did with the Edwards brothers, which probably suicide, because he's a big hitting light heavyweight, and they were super flies, and then they had me in bits, but it's what you got to do for the fans, isn't it? So yeah, anyway, I'm going to go and catch the other fights, and I'll see you in the next clip once we've got the semi-finals over and done with.
Majority decision, Dex Spellman!
I don't think it's the right decision, but I think...
Fuck that!
Right, we have ourselves a final, guys. So we've got Dex Bellman, who beat Joel McIntyre. And then we've also got Shikani Peters, the big, tall, wiry guy. Really tall, really wiry, really awkward. He beat Bacon. So we have ourselves a final. Both semi-finals were cagey affairs, as you'd expect. Probably want to leave a little bit in the tank for when it gets to the final. So can't blame the guys there, but hopefully we're in for fireworks on the final. Give the guys a break for the in-between sort of interviews. Let the guys focus. I mean, big money at stake, so don't want to be getting in the faces. But we've got some cracking interviews for you guys, which obviously I'll stick in this video as well and going out on Instagram, etc. So yeah, it's been a good night. Really enjoying it, and just looking forward to that final. Now we've got Idris Virgo on now. Former Love Island star, he's doing pretty well. I think he might nick it on points, to be honest, but he's like the sort of interim fight, and the finalists are preparing now. So like I said, we'll be in touch soon, give you a couple of the ring entrances etc. for the final, and then fingers crossed they'll be in high demand, but we can try and get hold of the winner and the loser as well, give them commiserations and see if we thought he could have done better. So shall see you in a bit.
Judges in favour of your winner by unanimous decision, and he is the Ultimate Boxxer 2 champion, ladies and gentlemen, Shikani Peters! He will be receiving the golden robe now, ladies and gentlemen, as presented by Paolo Malignaggi. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a huge round of applause, please, for your golden robe winner of Ultimate Boxxer 2. Stay back from the ring.
Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you very much.
Mate, unreal. From start to finish, mate. It's just controlled it well.
Yeah, man.
How'd you feel, man?
Brilliant, man. I enjoyed it, man. It was a brilliant spectacle. Brilliant show to be on. You know, big up to Ricky Atten and everyone who puts these kind of shows together, because without them, you know, I wouldn't be able to showcase my skills here. Massive respect to my coach, Paul Coonhan. You know, he's improved me as a fighter. And, you know, we're just going to continue to improve all the time. You know, I know he doesn't look for any credit, but behind the scenes, he's the man who puts me together with everything, and I just follow his instructions.
Fantastic, mate. So what are you looking at next? Titles? Is that what we're looking at, 2019?
Listen, I'm waiting for that phone call, man. Everyone knows what that means. Pressure on me to bring it, but yes, I did tell everyone, I didn't lie. I
said, mate, no pressure there,
I'm bringing
mate.
That home. I told everyone I'm bringing it home, so everyone, you put money on me. Merry Christmas.
Cheers, mate. It's a nice one.
So elegant. Good.
Nah! Oh,
Reece, he's not getting over this. Oh, it's too wobbly as well.
Nah, I'm easy, I'm easy. You being fucking serious? Fucking hell.
Fuck me, lad.
I'd have just dropped my wallet.
What?
On the other side as well.